Ursula felt Odin's body sag behind her, and the hand holding the knife dropped so that the blade now hovered over her chest.
"I've known for years this would come back to haunt me," he said, his voice slow and dark.
Ursula thought she caught a sob as he spoke.
"You can do the right thing your whole life, work hard and try to do better. But when the past catches up with you, all that's worth nothing."
"You mean when Yonatan raised his head after so long and started blackmailing you into suppressing the rape charge against him?" Ursula said.
"He was calling in an old debt, as he had every right to," Odin said. "But when you started digging into all this and demanding it to be followed up, he was scared stiff. He started calling all the time, going wild and expecting me to work some kind of miracle."
"It's over, Odin. Now it's time for you to let me go," Ursula said, hoping that the tension she could feel draining out of him was an indication that he was about to capitulate. But instead, Odin stiffened and moved his arm to hold Ursula in a headlock. Her chin rested in the crook of his arm, and the smell of onion from the blade gave way to the stronger odour of sweat.
"You have influence with Torbjörn," he whispered. "You can call him and let him spin a story on all this. Vefpressan takes the lead and all the other media follow."
"You mean the Torbjörn you were seen talking to outside the ministry? Didn't you see the news earlier? The cleaner Stella saw you getting out of his car and said it was obvious you had been arguing. What were you and Torbjörn plotting?"
"We've both been plotting with Torbjörn, each in our own way. Don't think I haven't noticed,"
Odin snarled, but before Ursula could formulate a reply, she saw Gunnar step towards them. Odin shouted something, and then Gunnar leapt, and all three of them fell to the floor.